In this example, we are given a figure which shows a parallel plate capacitor with plate separation D. Here the separation between the plates is D and plate area is A, where A is LB. We can see that L is the length of the plate. So here area A we can write as LB. Here we can state that this B is the width of the plates, which is connected with a battery of EMF V. And a dielectric slab of mass M and of same dimensions is inserted in the capacitor up to a distance x, as we can see here, and released. Now we are required to show that this slab will execute periodic motion, and we are also required to find its time period. Now in the solution, the very first thing we can recall that whenever a dielectric slab is inserted in a capacitor which is connected to a battery, the force on slab can be given as F is equals to epsilon naught BV square by 2D multiplied by K minus 1, that we already studied in the previous sections. And we can see that the force is a constant due to which the slab will start moving inward between the plates of capacitor with constant acceleration. So we can simply write constant acceleration of a slab is, A can be written as F by M, that will be epsilon naught BV square by 2MD multiplied by K minus 1. And in this situation, if it starts from rest as we have released it, it will travel a distance L minus X and it will completely fill the region between the plates, and then onward, due to its kinetic energy, it will overshoot in the other direction. And as soon as the plate will overshoot in the other direction, it will start experiencing a force in inward direction, and it will retard with the same retardation A. It will further come to rest and then it will come back, and finally it will reach the same position, and we can say it will execute the periodic motion. Or more precisely, we can say the slab will execute oscillations between the plates. And in this situation, we can see that during oscillation, the acceleration of plate is constant. That means it will not execute simple harmonic motion, but still, as acceleration is always directed toward the region between the plates, so it will be acting as a restoring acceleration. If we wish to find out the total time period of oscillation, that is, it's going to the other direction and coming back to the same position, we can find out the time required for the dielectric slab to fill the complete space between the plates, and the time period will be 4 times of this, because the same time the slab will take in going in other direction, same time it will take in coming back, and finally in this position. So we can say if T is the time taken by slab to fill the region, this implies we can write that the distance it has to travel is L minus X, which can be written as half AT square, because here A is the acceleration, T is the time taken. So in this situation, the value of this time we can write it as root of twice of L minus X by the acceleration. This implies the time period of oscillations of a slab can be written as, this time period is 4 times the time taken by the slab to fill the region between the plates. So this will be 4 times square root of twice of L minus X divided by acceleration. And here the value of acceleration is epsilon naught BV square multiplied by 2MD. And in denominator, we need to write this K minus 1 also. And now you can further simplify it. If you take this 2 common out, this will be 8, and V can also be taken out. So here I can write this time period due to a shortage of space. I can write here this will be 8 by V under the root MD multiplied by L minus X divided by epsilon naught B into K minus 1, that will be the answer to this problem.